Colorado, Mr. Polis, for purposes of a colloquy.
I thank and congratulate Chairman Price for his hard work on this legislation. My colleague, Congressman Roy Bell Allard, and I would like to engage the chairman in a colloquy for the purposes of highlighting the funding for alternatives to detention in H.R. 2892. Over the last decade, the United States has spent billions of dollars in the detention of hundreds of thousands of mostly non-criminal immigrants and asylum seekers. There are, however, viable alternatives to our current detention system, and they are generally more affordable and humane than detention itself. It's not surprising that the Immigration and Customs Enforcement, ICE, has also recognized the need for alternatives to detention, such as the Intensive Supervision Appearance Program, ISAP, and the Enhanced Supervision and Reporting Program, which includes electronic monitoring. The Homeland Security Appropriations Act for fiscal year 2010 funds these smarter and less expensive means of enforcing our immigration laws, allocating $74 million to expand alternatives to detention programs nationally.
Mr. Polis?
I yield to Congressman Roy Bell Allard.
Okay. Mr. Polis, I share your concerns about the financial cost of detention, and I am also distressed by the impact our current policies have on families and communities. Every year, hundreds of thousands of non-criminal immigrants are held in detention. Many of these immigrants are detained for months or years in one of several hundred detention facilities in the country. They often face significant challenges like inadequate access to medical care, legal assistance, and other necessary resources. Separated from their families and communities, they may languish in isolation and fall into depression. In some cases, entire families are held in prison-like conditions. I believe we can do better and have introduced legislation to address many of these concerns. I commend Chairman Price for recognizing the importance of funding alternatives to detention, a major step towards reforming our detention system.
I yield to Chairman Price.
I want to thank Representative Polis and Representative Roy Bell Allard, a fine, hardworking member of our subcommittee, for the work they've done on this issue, for highlighting the financial cost and the human impact of ICE's current detention policy. I, too, believe we can do better. While the average cost of detention is about $100 per person per day, alternative programs such as telephone reporting, unannounced home visits, local office reporting, and electronic monitoring cost on average less than $20 per person per day and are very successful. According to a recent ICE analysis of the program, the Intensive Supervision Appearance Program currently has a 99% total appearance rate for all immigration hearings, a 95% appearance rate at final removal hearings, and a 91% compliance rate with removal orders. This program has been successful at pilot sites in Colorado, California, Maryland, Kansas, Florida, and Pennsylvania. So therefore, ICE has sought funding to expand it. And this bill increases the budget, our bill increases the budget for alternatives to detention programs by 16% above the President's request.
I thank the chairman for highlighting more cost-effective and humane alternatives to detention and for recognizing the financial and human costs of our current detention system. I want to applaud his leadership as well as that of my colleague, Representative Roy Bell Allard of California, on this important issue, and I yield back the balance of my time.
I reserve the balance of my time.